Explosive night as we take a look at the tail of the tape for this one in the welterweight division. John Fitch and Marcelo Alfaia, 35-34, 6 feet to 5'11". There you see the weights and the reach advantage to John Fitch. We now set it inside the cage. That is where Jazz Securo has the official introductions.
Ladies and gentlemen, we're back at the Bank United Center in Coral Gables, Florida. This fight is scheduled for 3 rounds in the World Series of Fighting welterweight division. And now, introducing fighting out of the blue corner, his record sits with 16 wins, 6 defeats, and 1 draw. He stands 5 feet 11 inches tall and weighed in at an even 172 pounds. Fighting out of Coconut Creek, Florida, introducing Marcelo Grillo.
Keys to victory, very good on the ground, but you know you're fighting Fitch, so you gotta stay off the ground. Needs to have a lot of stamina to stop the non-stop pressing action from Fitch. And like I said, try to keep it on the feet and go for a knockout. If it does go to the ground, get Fitch in the guard.
And now, ladies and gentlemen, introducing his opponent on my left, fighting out of the red corner, his record, 27 wins, 4 defeats, and 1 draw. He stands 6 feet tall, weighing in at 170 pounds and a half, fighting out of Fort Wayne, Indiana, presenting John Fitch!
Fitch is striking, is getting better and better at American Academy of Kickboxing, a.k.a. he's going to non-stop push the action to take his opponent striking away and set up the takedowns. Once on the ground, do what he does best, ground and pound.
Well, John Fitch knows just how important this fight is, and he told us exactly what he wants to do once the fight begins.
In order to win this fight, I have to be aggressive. I have to make sure I'm avoiding his power and use pressure. Use pressure, drag him into the deep end and drown him.
And when the action begins, your referee is Troy Waugh.
So here we go, boss. John Fitch taking on Marcelo Alfaia in the welterweight division of the World Series of Fighting. This one's scheduled for 3.
Did Fitch train hard on the striking there at the American Kickboxing Academy? This is important.
Fighter, are you ready? Fighter, are you ready?
They have all these great strikers there. He's got to throw. Oh, that's too slow. He can't kick like that. He needs to go faster. There he is, looking for the takedown. Oh, look at here. Alfaia looking for a takedown and securing it. And he's looking to step over the mount. He might jump over there. Only one more knee to pass. See if he actually is going to do it. Fitch should be ready for this. He should keep pushing there. Keep pushing up with his right knee. You cannot let him step over.
Boston, one of your keys to victory, you talked about keeping the pace up. Who does this slower pace, more methodic pace favor, in your opinion?
Methodic pace, well, look at the bodies. You know, Fitch is the lean muscle mass. He can probably has probably more endurance than Alfaia has. He's got a lot of muscle. You need a lot of oxygen. So, the slow pace fights, I think, slowly but surely. Grinding, I think, would Fitch would be better than. But I'm talking going into the third round.
Yeah.
Got his back right away. Look at this. Look at this.
Something that does not happen very often to John Fitch. Giving up the back to Marcelo Alfaia.
Alfaia also caught the left arm of John Fitch. You see that? And he figured forelocked it. So he got only one arm, his right hand, to defend rear naked chokes. He's got to stay super calm now. And if I was him, I would press my jaw against my shoulder. Don't do it like you're doing right now, because they might slip under. It's very dangerous.
Trying to get the wrist control, but at the same time, Alfaia is just popping him with those nuisance shots.
He's got to break that grip with his right hand. Right now he can't do it, but Fitch has to push against the left knee of Alfaya. He's got to push that away so he can get his arm free. And it's off. It's free.
Alfaya exerting a lot of energy and now taking the back again of Fitch.
Great job here. He needs that hook, otherwise he might lose control. Body triangle. This is going to make it hard to breathe for Fitch.
Alfaya trying to lock up that shoulder.
He can even go now. Push the head forward, go both underarm. How do you call it? Double Nelson, full Nelson. In Holland, they call it a double Nelson. Full Nelson here. If he goes with his left arm underneath the armpits, then he could pull off a full Nelson. That would be something.
Fish just trying to find a way to pop out of this.
He's got to really watch out. You can't stand. He's got to watch methodically, make sure his jaw is protected, and then he might go stand.
Let go of his glove, John. Let go of his glove. Let go of his glove, John.
Now here I'm talking about all these big muscles.
Wow.
They're putting a lot of oxygen in there now. A lot of lactic acid because they're pulling.
Yep. And I was going to ask you, how much energy is Marcelo Alfaya exerting? I mean, he's the one that's really doing all the work and exertion. Fitch is just trying to ward him off.
That's it. Exactly right. They should favor Fitch in the striking department once he goes back to the feet.
Well, Alfaya certainly has him locked up in the midsection, unable to allow Fitch to really do anything at all as Fitch is trying to spin around, rotate, maybe use the cage as his friend, but still maintaining some kind of control on those wrists. And again, some heavy leather coming down from Alfaya.
You know what Fitch was doing there? Elbowing the thigh, not a bad idea at all. But you gotta do it the right way.
I'm watching close, we're good.
You talked about the Mohawk rule here in Florida. It's basically if you have a Mohawk haircut, that is the reason of the head you cannot attack of your opponent.
Yeah, that includes the top of the head. For the people who know the normal mixed martial arts rules, you're not allowed to hit the top of the head. So the Mohawk all the way from the front to the back.
Well, I think Alfaya is probably going to take this round as we go under 20 seconds. But, boss, John Fitch has done a great job of just maintaining it. How much energy basically has he there saved with Alfaya doing all the work?
He should go for a takedown now. Well, he will because he's got a lot of energy. But, I would say save the energy and go to round number 2.
We'll have the second round when we return to Coral Gables, Florida.
This isn't a sport for just normal people. I don't know if you want to call it a challenge or you just want to call it straight crazy. Now I'm where I need to be and I plan on going to the top. Can't sing and dance, so I might as well punch somebody in the face.
Oh, that is it! Take a look at Anthony Johnson! Steve Carl, the pride of Belle Plaine, Iowa, getting ready. He is part of the co-main event going head-to-head with Josh Berkman tonight. But we've got a good battle right now inside the cage in the welterweight division. John Fitch going head-to-head with Marcelo Alfaya. Boss Rudin, I have to say, I'd probably give that one to Alfaya, but Fitch did a great job defensively of warding off all the submission attempts that Alfaya was trying to throw at him.
Yeah, and now we're going to see if Alfaya spent a lot of energy. Because Fitch is coming forward, and he knows he needs to win the next 2 rounds. He's going to take him down. This is Fitch's game.
Yep.
And look at the power. If Fitch is going to fight like he fought against Eric Silva, leg lock attempt here from Alfaya. He's got to watch out. Good escape here from Fitch.
Fitch just rains down a big shot, puts Alfaya up against the cage.
And again, Alfaya grabs the leg. What Fitch can do now is he can sit on that hand. Oh, because then he has no defense there. Fitch got to pull this up. He cannot allow this guy to take him down. Alfaya, if he gets him on the ground, that is not a good thing. He needs to get back up. Alfaya showed in the first round he can keep him down.
So John Fitch comes out at the start of round number 2 with a big flurry. Gets Alfaya to the ground. And it's Alfaya once again taking Fitch's back.
Fitch is out. Nice. Beautiful scramble. Escape. Look at this. And he's pushing, pushing, pushing. This is Fitz's game plan. When he fought Eric Silva, and Eric Silva was one of those guys that I thought would go to the top, I mean, Fitz was all over him. And that's how we started round number two now. If we see that Fitz, he's going to win this fight.
John Fitch in the black trunks, Marcelo Alfaia in the white trunks.
Alfaia looks so much stronger.
And boss, I think for the folks at home that aren't familiar with MMA, this takes out a lot of energy. The defense and the tight clinch up against the cage, both guys are not just relaxing on each other, leaning on each other, they're both trying to break that hold and trying to improve their position.
Yeah, Alfaia's leaning forward, there's a constant pressure on his core. That fills up his leg, and that's it. And what I always say, your lungs are behind your core. And it starts pressing, filling up, bloating up, like bodybuilders, I would almost say. And starts pressing your lungs away. There's a lot of stress here now.
John Fitch trying to break that clinch of Alfaia.
And John Fitch is constantly having those underhooks. It's like having a little kid in your hand. Well, a big one. And lifting it the whole time. And that's why it's so hard. Right run when they break, it's going to be hard for them to strike. Because now they've been pulling. And for striking, is pushing. Or with a snap, of course.
So John Fitch right now has got himself a bit of a defensive stance here up against the cage. Alfaia has got his head down, trying to control Fitch.
Fitch should really start working here. He should trust his gas tank and go full blast. Pull him up with everything he's got. Then again, Alfaia is super strong. Just by the way, if you look at him, it's already, you see strength.
It all comes down to who can impose whose will on their opponent. And right now, both these men are locked into it.
Look at that.
As Alfaia is able to pick up Fitch and immediately takes the back again.
And back escape. I wanted to say, he's going to do a backdoor escape. He's going to do it. Yep, there he is. Beautiful. He doesn't want to repeat of round number one. There he is. Nice uppercut here by John Fitch.
Fitch connects on the uppercut. Alfaia looks gassed.
Yeah, and dazed a little bit. And you can see his muscles, his shoulders, you see they're all bloated up right now. There's pretty much a lot of leg acid in there. Punches start being less effective.
Alfaia comes back with a nice uppercut.
Yep.
Coming up on a minute to go here in round number two.
I had to expect that from somebody who was born on the same day as me. John Fitch, he just threw a liver shot. February 24th. Nice. Nice knee as well.
Fitch now slowly putting together some nice combinations.
He's got to pull him up. He's got to pull him up. He's got to pull the hands up. He's got to do something. Alfaia's going to take him down again. Alfaia. That's it. Pushing your hands up.
30 seconds to go in this round.
You see, the longer the fight goes, I told you, going to favor Fitch, I think, because Alfaia still has a lot of power.
It's John Fitch and Marcelo Alfaia as we come to the end of round number two, and we will see a third and final round in the welterweight division when we return to Coral Gables, Florida. Lovely Cat Kelly doing the ring card girl obligations tonight here at Bank United Center, Coral Gables, Florida, World Series of Fighting 6. And this is a good one in the welterweight division. John Fitch, Marcelo Alfaia, and Boss Rutten. I think I've got this one round apiece.
I think so too. And what I said before, my question is answered. John Fitch definitely worked hard on the striking, looking great in round number two, connecting with a few shots. Alfaia seems to be more tired, but he's coming forward and he's got a lot of power, so I might be mistaking as well.
Fitch does look to be the crisper fighter here in the early parts of round three. Alfaia, though, as Boss pointed out, has a ton of power.
Oh, there's that uppercut again. Now, Fitch fought a lot of fights,
yep,
and a lot of three-round fights, so he's been here. This is home turf for him. Great pro.
With 4:10 to go in this fight, we check in ringside with Joey Varner.
Thanks, Todd. I was in the corner of John Fitch, and his coaches are imploring him to keep the fight standing. They say, keep your back off the fence, take control of the center of the cage, let your hands go, and you'll win this fight.
Yeah, that's good advice, don't you think, boss?
I think so, too. Yep. He's got to watch out with his back against the fence, though. So as Joey said it, he had his back against the fence.
And I imagine if Joey Varner could be in two places at once, Alfaya's group would have said, get him to the ground.
Oh, yeah. Oh,
Fitch
he's
is just scoring.
Man, we see a new and improved John Fitch here. Look at that. Oh.
And you've got to think in the back of John Fitch's mind, he wants this victory so bad so he could get another shot at Josh Berkman, who fights later tonight.
Wow. And that was in his head in a training camp. I bet you had a picture of Berkman on the back. Go, I'll be back with you.
3 minutes to go in this one.
Fitch has got the bear hug here. That's better than a double under. It's going to be hard. Although Alfaya, is so strong, he's got to watch out for a hip toss.
You know, if this fight does go the way of John Fitch, you've got to think Marcelo Alfaya, after two rounds, thinks he had it. But it's that third round that John Fitch has really turned it on.
You know, he just scored another right body shot, the two shots to the head. Look at this. Everything is a hit.
His big body lock throws him up against the cage.
He wants to take the fight to the ground now, wants to be on top. He's got to watch out. I would say keep the corner's game plan.
Look at this, up against beautiful sprawl. Make Alfaya do all the work. And this late in the fight, as strong as Alfaya is, I don't know if he has the strength to get Fitch up off the ground for a slam.
He's got to pull. Fitch has got to pull. Alfaya's got to pull. He's got to pull his toe and send it to the side. Can he lock his hands? Almost. But it's a little too high. He wants to be a little lower, but because of the wide stance of Fitch, he can.
This is fantastic. Both these guys absolutely gassed Boss Rutten and still going at it.
Wow. 1.5 minutes, Fitch connect again with the right.
Under 90 seconds.
Oh, high kicks.
Fitch came in with all kinds of force, and Alfaya's in trouble.
Wow, big shots from Fitch here. These are power shots. Man, he wants to finish this fight. He's got to keep sprawling, push him down.
Under a minute to go. How is Alfaya fighting back after that punishment he just took?
This guy is very tough.
I mean, he took five clean shots to the grill from John Fitch, and he has the wherewithal to scramble up and try to lock him up.
Let me push him up against the fence. He might try to go for another takedown. Fitch is throwing uppercuts underneath the armpit. Nice hip movement here from Fitch. He knows it's only 25 seconds.
Alfaya climbs the back, but Fitch throws him on him. And that's going to about do it with 15 seconds to go. Alfaya just has nothing left in the gas.
But still coming back up.
What a fight.
Wow.
For the official decision, you're watching World Series of Fighting 6 from Coral Gables, Florida. The World Series of Fighting 6 from Miami, Florida is brought to you by Boost Mobile. Be heard. by CureFA.org. Help us with the fight against Friedreich's ataxia. Back inside Bank United Center in Coral Gables, Florida, at the conclusion of an exciting welterweight bout between John Fitch and Marcelo Alfaia, we go inside the cage. Jazz Sakura has the official decision.
Ladies and gentlemen, after three rounds of fighting, we will go to the judges' scorecards for your winner, and they have given us a split decision. What? Judge Tim Vanetta scores at 29-28, Fitch. Judge Rich Green scores at 29-28, Alfaia. And Judge Elicio Rodriguez scores at 29-28 for your winner by split decision, John Fitch!
John Fitch gets the win by split decision. As we take a look at the Boost Mobile highlights, round number one, boss, I think clearly it was Marcelo Alfaia that got that one.
Yep, that was his round, all over him. A lot of power, a lot of force. Got him in a body triangle, caught his arm. Did everything right.
Round number two, John Fitch comes out with a flurry early on, and Alfaia weathered it, and then he started to get after it, but it was John Fitch early, clearly, in the first minute and a half.
Yes, and I think he was going very strong. Look how he escapes here. We have another one that escaped the back door. Look at that uppercut landing really hard.
And the third and final round, I say this one is all John Fitch.
Everything he hit was almost connected. Look at that, uppercut left, dude. Those punches, yeah. So I didn't see the split decision.
And we send it inside the cage. Joey Verner has our winner.
John Fitch, congratulations on your victory. It was a back-and-forth battle. When that bell rang to end the fight, how confident were you that you did enough to get the decision?
I was fairly confident I did enough. I did a lot of damage, a lot of striking, a lot of stuff on top. He was able to control a lot of positions on me, which I wasn't expecting because he was really strong. But, you know, I don't think that was enough to win a fight.
He did a great job of controlling the positions. He also did a great job at taking you down. Were you surprised at his wrestling?
A little bit. I mean, he was so strong against the fence, I couldn't make the room I needed to get away and escape.
Tonight in the main event, first ever World Series of Fighting welterweight title on the line. Who do you like, Berkman or Carl?
Man, it's tough to pick, but I gotta pull for Berkman because I want that rematch and I want to do it for the belt.
Awesome. Well, once again, congratulations on your victory.
Thank you very much. Thanks for having me, guys. Love you, Miami.
Ladies and gentlemen, your winner, John Fitch.
Nice. So Fitch gets the victory, and we move on for two more great fights tonight. We will visit with Marlon Moraes.